In terms of other songs to try, I'm very partial to doing the bebop tunes to get a sense of swing in your system. To me, there was a golden age, the late 50s, mid to the mid 60s, where the timing was just beautiful. Now there's people can swing with straight eights. I mean, there's a lot of different ways you can swing now. But in terms of a learning tool, I think that time in the bebop era is probably the best. I like Anthropology, Dahoud, and Donna Lee, okay? And I'm going to put those up on my website. With Dahoud, for example, what you would do is you know, that reminds me of something. There are a couple of other things with swing, I gotta say. These are kind of like little softer indicators of swing. It's not only about accenting the and delaying the eighth note, the upbeat of the eighth note. When you hear players in trios or whatnot, a lot of times the piano player is playing slightly behind the beat. And they do this to give a sense of relaxation to the music. If you go too far behind, it creates tension, but if you're a little bit behind, it actually is kind of relaxing. And then when you anticipate a beat, or you play in front of a beat, and that's what I just did, it reminded me of it, it actually energizes the playing. So, you know, that's kind of a crescendo. Listen to this note, I rush it a little bit. Okay, it's different than okay, where I played right on the beat. It's there I did. See, I'm emphasizing a little too much, but the okay, I'm going a little bit fast. I'm playing it just a little bit before the actual timing of the note comes in. And it's kind of an energetic device. You don't really expect it. It comes in a little sooner than you expect. And you especially hear that, I think, with a lot of horn players who do that. And they go between the laying back to playing these anticipation beats that are a little ahead. And it just creates a lot of variety and interest in the rhythmic flow. So let me say a little something about the end game here. You know, we've been talking about learning how to vocalize and incorporating that into your playing. The end game is to be able to vocally mimic great horn players, great swing players, great solos, and incorporate Charlie Parker's swing, for instance, into your own playing. But because the voice is intrinsically more specific, you're actually able to take in more information doing it vocally first, and then taking whatever you can of that and translating it into your fingers. In other words, you know, you can scoop with your voice, you can't scoop with your fingers, but you can kind of get in there to mimic a scoop, for instance. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sing along with the recording. I wish I'd picked something a little bit slower, because I don't think this is necessarily the best song to start off with because of its speed, but it just kind of gives an example of where you're going with this. Okay. Okay. Okay? So basically what I'm doing there is I'm leading with my voice and I'm trying to then mimic as best I can with my fingers. Okay, what I actually do is I cut this up into little snippets and I'll just put it in a repeat loop to where, like, you just take the ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-bop, okay, ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-bop, ba-do-ba-do-ba-do-bop, etc., etc., and you do it, and then you add another little snippet to it, and you build just based on the small little phrases that you can do. The other thing, and it probably deserves another video, is this is the way to learn great solos also, because if you then take little small snippets of like 8 measures, 16 measures, you learn them vocally of like a Charlie Parker solo. And after you learn it vocally, singing along with the record, then you sit down and you play it. What you're doing is you're getting very non-pianistic solos into your hands, into your voice and in your mind, as opposed to doing things that we tend to do because it's easy to reach. We're doing solos that are more suited for horn players, and it's a way to kind of stretch your playing and make the melodies that you do more authentic. So anyway, I just wanted to say that's kind of where this is going, just to give it a little bit of context. I think that might be a good place to stop. I hope you found it interesting. This is just a kind of introduction. It's certainly not all-inclusive. It's also more my personal impressions, because to my knowledge, there's not a lot about this that's been written down. So this is kind of cobbled together from what I've picked up through the years. I'm signing off. This is 7-Note Mode. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found this helpful.